ask you something.
Okay.
Take care of my son. Why am I on child support?
Because it's deeper than child support. It's actually like damages for breaking my heart and us not being a family.
Oh, there you go. There you go.
Because I'm doing this shit by myself, Raymond.
Fake ass teeth. Then why won't you let me see him?
I know that he is the only thing you love in this world. And if I can hurt you that much by keeping away what you love, then I'm going to do it because I am miserable. You must be miserable too.
It makes no sense. We could be cordial. We could be friends.
We can't be friends because I'm still in love with you. And you're sitting here moving on with your fucking life.
Making this about you.
What am I supposed to say? It's never been about him. It's about me.
There are no men. It's either they're old and have no hair, or it's...
The problem is that as you were busy partying and running through men like a hot knife through butter, you were also getting old. Now your pool of men are younger and no longer find you attractive. The old ones are already settled down and don't want you either. Sorry. You've run out your clock. But keep blaming men. It looks so good on you. Maybe try a simp.
Me listening to these hoes lie.
Is her gala here in Hollywood? Well, she was fucking my boss and gave my boss chlamydia. And here I am, the hoe, alleged hoe. Yeah, I am a hoe. But everyone thought that I was the one fucking my boss, and in all reality, it was this bitch. And so it just literally got to the point where all that shit came out, that she got him sick, that, because he was married, can you put your seatbelt on, or behind you, you don't have to put it on, but behind you, he's a king, or, he's a prince in Africa, and so he came out here back in 2013, worked with Global Canvasser, which was a nonprofit, and then worked with UNICEF in the United Nations. That's where I got on, and I was able to.
How many of you have had to fake an orgasm? Like, seriously, fake an orgasm?
Well, that's just too bad for y'all. We got ours, and we're very much satisfied. But did you know, in early January, the Earth is at its closest point to the sun? Look it up. I think it's because we need to keep these balls drained. I think that's what it is.
One time spark, broad day all night. A fuck nigga, that's that shit I don't like. A snitch nigga, that's that shit I don't like.
You gotta flip that on its head, because it's like chasing women shit is for the birds, bro. And once you do that, like, once you tell a girl how interested you are in her, then it automatically, like, subconsciously makes her slightly less interested in you. And then they're, like, looking for reasons why to disqualify you, or why they shouldn't hook up with you, because they know they got you.
You can trust people. It's okay. Let them into your heart.
Cheat on that bitch because she don't really love you. She out there sucking dick every night. calling you up the next morning with cum on her breath.
Can you play that song I liked? The one from when I was young?
Some men had to realize they're only needed for her. Don't nobody want to love you, bruh. Look, most men just want to hit them cheeks, then they back to the streets anyway. That's why we always got women crying about how they can't find a good man. But women, y'all need to come to the realization that a lot of y'all are not girlfriend material. A lot of y'all will never find a man. A lot of y'all are not wifey material because a lot of women are delusional and think that they're the best of the best. Every woman thinks that she is the best and it gets no better than her. When a lot of these dudes is just coming in, beating them cheeks, and then they back to the streets, and nobody's gonna love you. Men, we're okay with that. You know, we're okay with not ever being in a relationship. A lot of men have come to grips and terms with that, but a lot of y'all women have not. And y'all, oh my God, I want the Dirk in India, but the Herb and his girl. Nah, you're not that. You're not getting that. You're getting them cheeks beat, and then homeboy back to the streets.
Hello? Open your door.
What do you want?
I want to talk to the grown-up who lives here.
Why? What happened?
Answer the door.
What happened?
Answer the door.
No, I don't even know who
you are. I'm your neighbor.
Is something wrong? Oh, can you tell me what it is?
Open the door.
I'm angry. I really don't want to open the door unless you calm down.
Open the door.
I'm sorry. Who are you? Can you just tell me if something went wrong or if something happened? I'm not aware.
There is something wrong.
Made you angry.
Who are you?
Well, can you tell me what?
You're the mother of this house?
I'm the mother of this house.
Great. Well, we've never met, so let's meet. If your cat doesn't stop pissing and eating and biting all of the things at my house when I don't own a cat and you do, I'm going to get the police involved because I am fed up. My son is very allergic to cats. Your cat will not stay out of my yard, my house, my garage. He gets into my house. Keep
your cat.
It's your cat. I've already met your husband about it. It's your cat. Yes, you do, and you don't keep any of them inside. Keep your cat inside. Your orange cat. If you would open the door, I can show you. Your cat doesn't have to come to my house either. But you know what? That's fine.
There is not one single thing in this entire world that a mother can do that a father cannot. Not one.
Load up on guns, bring your friends, fun to lose, and to pretend she's over.
above all the self-assured. No, I'm not a jerk.
Let's keep it a ban on this one. Some of y'all are just attention whores. Like, y'all have a very unhealthy desire to keep people that y'all do not want around just for emotional satisfaction. You know for a fact you don't have any emotional feelings towards this person, but you want them to stay around and chase you and chase you and chase you to boost your ego. It's really a sad fact that your craving for attention is so high that you would be upset that a dude that you never wanted gets in a relationship. Let's be real, it's giving childish, it's giving goofy, respectfully.
Since I first got here, I never stopped working. Today was when all the work paid off, and you know, God put me in a position, and I just try to take advantage of my opportunities.
Taking my eyes off you. 3 days later.
Hey, SpongeBob.
Hi, Patrick.
I don't think you understand how little validation men get. Like, women will get compliments just for being a woman. You'll get validation for being a certain gender. That's an amazing thing. That's a crazy thing. Like, men will get hated on just for being men. Understand that men will get their first flowers typically at their funeral. They get very few compliments over the course of the year, genuine compliments, and they get almost no validation in their relationships. It's usually about their woman, their female. Women are flooded with attention, compliments, positivity, you know, from a young age, and that's an amazing, beautiful thing. But you guys got to understand, like, men don't really get that, and that's why when you compliment a guy, it lights him up. Men really like go through a lot of stuff. Men are expected to provide support, take care of themselves with no reassurance from the world whatsoever. It's very difficult sometimes for men.
Marriage and sex have been devalued. People engage openly in adultery without shame. Then wonder why STIs and abortions are commonplace. What example is being set for the
meanest thing a woman has ever said to you? For me,
oh, I got plenty of those, but this one took the cake. I was in college in Pennsylvania at Cheney University. My boy D had this girl he was messing with. She had this fire fine ass friend that I really wanted, so I asked him. I said, hey bro, put me in the dough, just, you know, introduce me or whatever. He told me he got me. He was a man of his word. We saw the females one day coming out the laundry room while we was waiting on the elevator, and my boy D went up to him. He was like, hey, my boy Ray, he really like you. He wanted to get to know you. He wanted me to introduce him, you know, to you and things of that nature. So I'm just keeping it cool, you know, smiling or whatever. She turned around, look up and down, and said, "Hell no, he ugly." Out loud, like I could hear her. Like I'm like, we like 2 feet away from each other. I could actually hear her. My heart, it was like crumbling in front of me. Like I could feel it, like doing like this in my chest. I respect her for being truthful, though.
What we do, we kill deer, murder them, bucks, does, bambies, don't give a fuck. Brown is down. And we go spearfishing. So that means we go underwater and we kill fish. Murderers of fish. Fish and deer. No, we eat it. Why is that nasty? Who eats seafood when we're in the Great Lakes? It's not the sea, it's the Great Lakes. Oh, there we go.